Family, I am Mr. Pleasant.
I'm Mrs. Pleasant.
And welcome to a Pleasant Lover. New week, new us, new everything on the God. Hey.
Fast is over.
Oh, it is over?
Church.
It's over today? I've been doing so, like, in it. I didn't realize it was over.
Because it's a part of our lifestyle now.
There it is. What's going on? We are on our week three of our Daniel's fast. We finished. Well, I should say we finished third week of the Daniel's fast.
Yeah.
Me personally,
yeah.
On that vegan trip, your boy trying to do his thing. You check out our Instagram and all that good stuff. You see your boy trying to slim down. I ain't been in this shirt in a minute. You know.
He looked good, all right.
It used to be bulging. Let's get in there. So we're gonna try to match my baby. So what's going on, guys? I hope y'all having a good day, week, whenever you're watching this. Please find some way to celebrate life. I know right now it is going crazy. People trying to get the vaccine.
Yeah.
You know, the coronavirus still out there.
Yeah.
You know, nation divided. Find some way to celebrate life. Okay, God put us on this earth to live life and life more abundantly. What are you doing if you're not doing that? Find some way.
Guess what? You still breathing if you watch this.
Hello.
That's something to shout about right there. That in itself.
Some people are not
breathing. Because
right
some
now.
People ain't breathing.
And they had no choice. They had no choice. It was
my God.
It was our boy. Not our boy. He don't know me. But I watched him growing up. Larry King passed away. At the time of this taping. Yeah.
The famous baseball player passed away.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So many people were losing, but if you're watching this, we're still here. You're still able to breathe, and hopefully you're still able to talk.
Telling Anton Fisher.
And if you're able to hear this word, you're still here.
Yes.
Taking the good air God gave us, and let's keep striving on. Amen?
Yes.
So we hope you guys are staying safe. We hope your family's good. Please like, comment, and share this video, because y'all helping us. We've hit 100 subscribers. 100 subscribers.
So thank y'all guys so much.
Yes.
Family, friends, people we don't know. I've seen people like, who are you? I don't know who you are. You're just subscribing. I think one of my former students described, what's up, Dallas? Thank y'all so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you for the love. I hope this is enriching your life. Mm-hmm. And like you see, I told y'all we're going to bring out more content. And it's coming out every week.
Yep, so keep
looking out on Saturdays, Sundays, and Mondays, and sometimes throughout the week. Because we will be dropping little nuggets for you guys.
Most definitely.
So what are we talking about today, Will?
So this week, as always, this is a new year, okay? What was the first week about? It was just a quick introduction to the whole veganism. Then last week, we got weak. Because we got weak so we can be strong. And then this week, as we're going through the week, going to the day, ins and out, the struggles of the life, I was like, God, like, he keeps putting this thought in my head, like, willpower. In the past, we do this. We start diets, we start resolutions, we start, goals, promises to people that we love, people that we don't like. We like making all these promises, and then after 2 or 3 weeks, it just falls. Why do they do that?
Because we ain't got no willpower.
Because not only we ain't got no willpower.
We human beings ain't got no willpower.
I mean, I have willpower to an extent, but when that Saturday comes, my boy's like, hey, man, you want to go to, you know, get a drink?
Wait,
you want to go
wings, brew wings,
wild wings, buffalo wild wings.
I miss the chicken wings.
That's how we're going to be the new restaurant, The Wings. Just the wings. You walk in and you get a wing in your mouth. So, yeah, that's what happens. Life happens, you know? You just don't do it. You know, I was talking to a friend, it was yesterday. And I guess he didn't realize I was like how deep we were in, where I was not even drinking. And he was like, if I get a drink, I'll pass out.
You can't drink.
Wait, I feel like that's the opposite, uh-huh. But that's what he said. He said, all right, what? You stopped drinking? I was like, yeah, I had a sippy sip in a minute. You know, he's like, if I did that, then, you know.
He helped us through it.
And it was, I mean, that's just because it was part of the fast, you know. Yeah. Even after the fast is over, I don't plan to do as much because a lot of it's just excess sugar I don't need, you know. So,
yeah.
But yeah, you just realize that some people just, you know, can't do it. Even us. There's many times where we started in 2017, 2005. Let's go back through the decades where we started and stopped. And I think what made it, I was like, what is making it different? Why is this so much easier this time around? One, goals. Goals, me and my baby, we got goals. We got things we want to do.
Together. Not individually.
Yes.
We're married, so thank God for us being on
the same page. Yeah, we got goals. That's one. But sometimes goals can only take you so far. You know, it also, we don't have the willpower. We have what we call the God power. It's just a song said, the God flex. You know, the spirit power. You know, when I'm driving down that Burger King, I think what makes it different is usually what happens is we hear it, like we said last week, we hear it, like God said, you don't need that. But we're like, did he say that? Like,
did he really say that?
Or, you know,
in the upright.
And I start, and then what also happens is we start real small, like, you know, like, I think, 2 years ago, we were trying to do it, and it started with like maybe like a taco. You're like, one taco.
One carne asada. I will stop. I'm gonna stop at your taco. I said, okay. You want some? I was like, sure. Give me a quesadilla.
A quesadilla. Come on, you would say I taught you for a little bit for school.
Quesadilla.
Was it Napoleon Dynamite?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Get you a diet quesadilla.
That's what I said.
So that happens. We start out simple, and by March, you know, spring break and then Easter, we eat pot roasts
and
bread on bread. Oh, you got peach cobbler and an apple pie. Both of them. I'll see you in 2022. That's what happened. And mind you guys, it's always no judgment. That's just, I mean, we're just telling you the reality. We're not telling you you're wrong.
Our reality.
But we if you really have this goal in your mind to lose weight, to do whatever you want to do, and it incorporates some kind of restriction, we always fall short. The Apostle Paul said it best in Romans 7:15-19. In fact, I don't understand why I act the way I do. I don't do what I know is right. I do the things I hate. Instead of doing what I know is right, I do wrong. After a while, you got to realize that we can't depend on ourselves. I love myself. I feel like I'm an intelligent person. I feel like every year I get a little wisdom.
And let me chime in on that.
Because, say it.
As you said, we're intelligent people. I think our intelligence got ahead of ourselves. Big time.
That's what happened.
We're like, okay, I accomplished this degree. I accomplished this degree. I should be able to tackle this weight. I should be able to tackle these friendships. I should be able to do these things.
Yes.
These are in me. I can do it.
Sometimes it's not a book.
And it was like, nah. Friendships, family relationships, co-workers, what career to go to next, what adventure to go to next, what business opportunity should you step into next, how to limit our diet, how to change our lifestyle. Right. Like, it's so many things that go along with this. It's like, with everything, like, you have to really, like, we keep doing the wrong thing because we think we too smart. we thought we were smart enough.
I think that's what makes it different. This time around, I humble myself. Like I said last week.
Big time.
Last week, I told you this, and I'll say it again. I humbled myself in front of Sierra. Before, she was like, we're going to do this vegan thing. And then I was like, oh, I know. Okay, we'll do the vegan thing. And then I didn't confide in her. I didn't depend on her. I didn't let her, you know, do what she needs to do. She is my wife. She's my partner in this. We are teammates. When there's a gap, she fills it in. You know, when there's when she creates a gap, I fill it in. So that's what happened this time around. I humble myself, not only to Sierra, because I love Sierra, but she could fail. One day she could fail. She could fail. I humble myself before God. I thank God every time. Sierra even caught me one time. Not caught me, but she saw me one time. I was after I had finished exercising. Usually the guy's like, put your hands up and think about a good day. No, I was praising God. Because there's some people that still, what I was doing, even though I'm a big person, I could still move. God gave me enough grace, don't make me cry up in here, that I could still exercise. There's some people that can't do it. You know, they have to get knee replacement. Their back is messed up. They can't do it. So now they're stuck at the weight there are, but God gave me grace enough, you know, and warned me enough to a part where my heart hit itself, accepted it, and said that I'm going to exercise, I'm going to take care of my body. And that's why I have to praise God. I have to humble myself and say, God, I cannot do this on my own. That's why I don't have willpower anymore. I have God power.
Yeah,
and that's what we need. That's what our message we're trying to get to you guys today. If you really want to do something in life, you really want to strive, stop trying to do it all on your own. There's nothing wrong with, remember when you were a kid and you couldn't, reach for something on the top shelf, your daddy or your mom picked you up, or they said, get the stepladder. You depended on something. We get older, we get out of high school, we get out of college, we get a degree, we get 15 degrees, and then we're like, oh, I know everything. Now, no, you don't.
Don't know
nothing. This world is eons old. You're 35, 45 years old compared to eons.
Yellow.
That's not how it works. Yeah. Depend on God, okay? I know there's people out there who are atheists, don't believe God. I get it. But I just don't know how to do it. I can't. I have to live my life with some kind of source.
And if that's my source. If that mean I'm weak, like our last video said, that mean I'm weak. So God is all I need to make me strong and make me be able to do whatever He has for me to do in His world. So I'm gonna just be weak. Let God fill me. I feel like I remember when I was a praise dancer. We would say this word. Well, our name of our group was called Yielded Vessels of Praise.
Nice.
And now it came back to me that when I was a praise dancer, I yielded myself a lot to God. That really helped me get through high school.
Yes.
And shout out to Miss Barbara Yarrow. I love you. I love you and all your wonderfulness. But because I was in that, now I'm like, to be a yielded vessel, you really have to empty yourself.
Yes.
And when I was praise dancing, I would empty myself, take away all the fleshy things, and allow God to use my body to praise His name, whatever song we did. And I feel like in life, we all need to be more humble, but also empty enough so that God can fill us. We have so much junk around us all the time. We consume a lot of junk, either in our mouth, in our nose, in our eyes. And sometimes we need to just shut, and focus on God. And then hopefully, you're able to get out of that rut you're going through, relationship you're going through, whatever it is that's preventing you from doing the purpose or the will of God in your life. So
right.
We have to just get back to Him. That's
right,
what
right, right. Even the Bible says in Romans 8:8, those who are in the flesh cannot please God. They're, like my baby said, there's no avoiding it. The world is the world. You have to go to work. You have to, you know, talk to other people. But at the same time, like she said, just find a way to, so it's just like taking a shower every day, you know? You just,
it really is.
Like, hey, let me put some gospel music. That's why, like, it's good to have to put some gospel music in the day or both at the end of the day and in the night, just so you could cleanse yourself so that you could be a, clean that vessel out. Coming in there with these dirty shells and thinking that we're going to go up in here and try to take care of it. That's what, and even that dirt is sometimes, like we were saying, our intelligence. That intelligence would be dirt. I have a math degree, Sierra has a biology degree.
Yeah.
I don't mean squat to God.
At all.
your righteousness is like filthy rags in the sight of God.
And you know, I just had a thought, like, you know, like when we say, like, at churches, you know, people are like, yeah, don't judge people when they come to church. You know, I think a lot of us have done that as Christians. But when you just tell someone to come to church as you are, you're telling them we are full of junk, as we say. And if you come to church or come to God as you are, you're saying, I'm taking one step closer to Him.
Yes.
He will meet you there.
Right.
And then you'll be like, oh, you feel all this love, and then you are empty. Then He fills you with your love. It is the most wonderful thing that could happen to you. And Ephesians 3:20 says this, now to Him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think, according to the power at work within us.
Woo.
You see what I'm saying? So we think we got it all. When he got everything that we need.
So if you're good with adequate, if you're good with complaints and mediocrity, cool. Depend on yourself. But if you want to go far beyond, which I had to do so I could get serious about this weight loss. Sarah, way in front of me. With that, before me to get serious, I had to depend on God so I could go abundantly.
And with relationships, I feel like the past maybe 3 years for me, I would say I have been broken by different relationships, friendships, and I've been broken within myself. And that brokenness, I was like, God, why won't you take me through this? Like, I'm a good person. That was my thing. I'm a good person. Like, come on, man. Like, I ain't do nothing wrong to nobody. But God was like, honey, it ain't about you.
Yeah.
It's about what I'm trying to get through you to everybody else. What I'm trying to do for you, for others. And that's the mindset I think Christians should need to start having. We should have had it a long time ago. But junk of the world, we try to consume to be validated by the world when the world does not validate us at all.
No.
Only our relationship with God.
No.
So let's get back to that.
Back to
2021, I have chills because earlier today I listened to this wonderful Tasha. I love you. I love you, honey, because my husband brought this to me. I was like, oh my God, you didn't say it 2-3 times. Now look,
we're not even in the same room, and God still.
And it's just like
he filled it.
And
place up.
Oh my God, it's just wonderful. So that's what I'm saying. When you really yield yourself to Him. And people say they don't have time for God. Help. I want to make sure y'all understand that it's not about an hour. It's not about a whole day. It's not about a whole week. It's not about a whole year. It's about spending, if you got 5 minutes before you go wake up your kids, if you got 5 minutes when the alarm go off and you try to go turn it off, while you lay there, pray to God.
Yes.
Or just say thank you. I have air. I can see. I can hear.
Yes.
I can talk. Start worshiping Him. Just 5 minutes. Just start there. Just 5 minutes. Take some time. When you drive, you feel that intuition of, thank you, God. Keep on driving. It's a relationship. It's a communication with the one above. That's all that it is. And I hope y'all see that it's just that easy. Life is so difficult. And we make things so difficult because the world has made things so difficult.
Yes.
And God is a very, He's a grandiose, wonderful God. And He has set up so many, as Will said earlier, the trifecta.
Yes.
We have a trifecta working for us, right?
Yes.
Which is God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. They're working for us.
All up in here.
Okay? Yes. We little gods to the big God. You know what I'm saying? Because he left the Holy Spirit to work within us, right? So work it out. Just use it. Use it to your best benefit so that you can do what He has called you for in the earth. Everyone's like, that was my big struggle. God, you asking a lot, man. How am I supposed to do all of this stuff you talking about? You giving me these visions and dreams that people prophesied over me. Lord, how little old me gonna do all of that?
Right.
And I'm like, okay.
Right there. Ephesians 3:20.
And I'm like, okay,
above,
so I got
all we can ask the thing.
All above. And I'm like, how am I supposed to, I gotta do all of that. And that's what I'm thinking, my analytical mind, my scientific brain. But God is bigger than that. He's so bigger. And I'm sitting here waiting, walking, praying, and worshiping Him as we get through 2021. I watched this documentary, but this YouTube channel, and it was, I guess, atheist against Christian.
Okay.
No. It was, she was an atheist, but she was raised, I think, Hindu or Muslim, one of the two. And she said, I was raised to believe in God, but I've come to find that God, I'm a little small speck in the world. He is too big to even care about me. So I don't understand how something so grandiose could care about little old me. That blew my mind. That if you're thinking that, please erase that from your life.
Yes.
Because God is big for a reason. Because
right.
He cares about all of us.
Yes.
And so if you feel a little goose above, if you feel a little joy, a little anything, just say thank you.
Thank you.
And he will come to wherever you are. So we hope that this has blessed you because it has blessed us. God is working. Y'all know we still fasting, but we are.
Yeah.
It's God. It's all God. It's all Him for sure. But we thank you guys for checking in. Please go watch our other videos, our vegan vlogs, if you want to call them. We have a new one coming out where we're cooking.
Yeah.
Go check that out.
Yeah. Married at First Sight recap.
Yeah, go check that out.
Cool show about relationships. We love that. Yeah. So
we love you guys. Be safe out there, and we'll see y'all in the next video. Bye.